Okay. Actually, we're getting ready to, let me see, we started already. You know, I want to give a shout out to YouTube. Actually, I'm talking to April. She's out there in, where you live at, April? Wilmington. Yeah, but I knew that. Anyway, she's in Wilmington, and I'm not going to tell you where she work at, but I just want one of them Taco Bells. Anyway, I just want to give a shout out, and we're just going to talk about, you have any questions, April? And what was that, April? Cause okay, so actually, what April wants to know, because you can't hear her on the phone, is that basically what is the difference and why are we lacking in slacking? She wants to know why we lacking in slacking in this great big country called America. What has happened is that the preachers is basically went back, you know, just as we was released from Egypt. And we wandered around arguing about what we were going to do instead of taking root down and basically establishing ourselves, right? What is happening now, after we got out of slavery, as what they would call slavery, you know, we stepped into what they call salary. And we still held on to basically the coming forth of a savior. The word savior, S-A-V-I-O-R, is actually S-A-V. The V is actually the U, because when you have the double U's, you'll see two V's. So the V is the U, and S-A and U is actually say. So the Savior is the Sayer. And now the Sayer is here, because the Sayer is in you. You are actually a part of the body of Christ. So with that information that you have learned, now you must go forth and actually deal with reality. Because going backwards, that was the past. And this is why it's said in the book that you hold, which you call the Bible. It says, let the dead bury the dead. So because the new life that is given unto us, basically we have to use that. And that's where the difference between knowledge and knowing. Knowing is basically continuous. And knowledge is something that's fixed or something from before, something that's said. But basically what is happening now through the knowledge of what's going on today in the law, because that is actually the instruction. That is the only facts, is the law. It's the only facts, because that which governs your movement, governs your life, governs your marriage, your business, anything that you want to do that restricts your movement. You see, you must learn how to basically use it, and you must master that. And what has happened is that the only reason that people didn't master the law of this particular country is because the spark, you see, which I am, you know, did not come. So now that I'm here, I'm actually referring you back. The word free is actually the word refer. I'm referring you back to the now, which is what we need to be doing now. And what we need to be doing now is to understand our total circumference, what they call due to knowledge, understanding your surroundings, and what makes you the person that you are. And actually, we are what you call from, or men from the womb. So the womb had the privilege of basically, she has the privilege of doing what she needs to do on the earth. This is her earth. The earth was actually given to her. And the children that she bare two children. And in the scriptures that actually I'm going to rewrite with your Bible that you hold holy, is actually not holy. The reason why they call it holy, because you're actually a body and a soul. And within the body, the instructions for your energy, right? So they state the holy, you know. This book is holy because it's for the inside of the energy that you are. You are a living soul in that particular body. So basically what's going on is the information that you held on to, you see, is the Holy Bible. But now we have went back, we've been through what they call what Moses said, we've been through what Abraham said. You know, we showed you about creation and recreation and what they call Bada, you know, and Khalik, you know, creation and the making of creation, the recreation, the Big Bang Theory, you know, and actually the renewing of our history, You know, and we have left, you know, the things that we did, the rites or the rituals that people do now, we have left that with them so that would ease their what they call their beastly nature. Because what happened, it was certain people that was chosen, you know, to come out of evolution. Everybody comes from the amoeba and on to, you know, different cells and different organisms, you know, till we got to what they call the ape, chimpanzee, the monk. This we have the monks in China, stuff like that. Everybody has had a different piece of information. So what's going on now is that we now have to leave the Bible, put it down for a side, and we have to get into the law. So we can revise the law and help those who have established this country. This, the symbol that we actually going to use now is going to be the Statue of Liberty. The Statue of Liberty is the womb man, which is her earth, you see, and the children that she bear must actually listen to her. So she must be reprogrammed because of education and the misuse of the system. You see, she has been programmed to be an object of desire. The things that she should have done, you know, as far as nurturing and caring, she was sidetracked to working and being a servitude for the children that she bare. See, man took advantage of her because, but it was written in the Bible, but it was translated different when it says that the seed of the devil. The devil is D-E-V-I-L. D-E-V-I-L is devil, but actually if you look at the word itself and the symbol is L-I-V-E-D, which means lived. She actually brought him through, nurtured him, he lived, but he was the opposite or the opposing of her, the opposite sex. So he was the opposing of her, he wasn't the duplicate. Only the daughter is the duplicate of the womb man, and she is the one with the privilege to reproduce again. Man is actually a seed carrier and a servant to the woman in the form of protection, you see, and guidance. You see, the guidance part is what she puts in is what she will get back out. But she has not been able to give man, her child, all over the world, the right instructions because he comes to be number one, and we're going to give you that. You are number one. He is number one, but you are the original. If you look at the numbers, you'll see that you have zero, then you have one, then you have two, three, on down the line, right? Each number represents something. So he was actually number one, but you are zero. The one man is zero, and that means from. So the helper of the one man is the spark. The spark is minus one. And the same moon, M-I-N, in U.S., which is minus, right, means from us, which was the spiritual world. This is why every child that the womb man had, she called him son. And they said son was the light. The son was the light. But the son was the word soon. Soon that someone would come to help the womb man. Now, getting back to what's going on, to deal with this planet Earth, right? First of all, the planet it plan was man's thing that he put through trade, through custom, through laws. He actually outwritten and took the authority of the woman away and left it in the house as the host of the house. Actually, she was the host or the hostage. She was H-O-S-T-A-G-E. A-G-E represents G-E-A and age, which is G-E-O also, which is G-O, which is earth. So the earth was put as the host of the house, was the hostage, and that's what they call it, the home, which was home in this particular thing. And only to World War II was she actually given her independence because this particular country couldn't deal with running the country and having that world war. And war was actually genocide of killing her firstborn because they knew that the Savior would come to help her. So every firstborn, they made and draft laws to kill or to put into war. War is the reverse of what they call war, which is going back into the animal kingdom. So now we're into the law